Hey everybody, Johnny Laser here, and today we're going to be doing engraving on curved surfaces. Actually, it's very easy to do. It's a little slower because the machine slows down with a curved surface. But what we're going to do is we're going to engrave this wooden spoon. And here we have a nice curved surface here in both directions. And yeah, you can see that. So this is what we're going to engrave today. Let's get to it. I'll show you how it's done. And here we are. We're going to take our wooden spoon here, and we're going to place it into the machine. And the back is relatively flat, so all we have to do is make sure that the side here is relatively straight. Not bad. Alrighty. Now, let us go into the programming of a curved surface. Alright, here we are. We're about to switch over to curved surface. Now, up here on your menu, you'll see I have it on process on base plate. We click that on, and we have base plate, roller, chuck, screen preparation, conveyor, and curved material. So we'll click on curved material, and right here there's some instructions. You can click view if you want. And what we're going to do is, right beside curved material is a little grid pattern. We want to click that. Now what we're doing is we're going to be marking a rectangle, basically the two corners. And let's do that now. We'll mark one now, right there. And we go over here to mark. It'll come down and mark it. It'll do it twice. Now we're going to mark the opposite corner over here of where we want it to finish. Alright, now it tells me that both corners are marked. We click next. Now it's asking for points. What it's going to do is it's going to go along this grid pattern and mark every depth on that point. Alright, and that'll give it a mesh surface. Now you can click in here and add more rows, add more columns. The more rows and columns you add, the more points you have. It's going to take longer to measure, but the more rows and points, the more finer of a mesh you will have. So depending on the curve you have, is depending on how fine and how rough you want it. So let's increase that to 7 rows, and we'll increase that to 9 columns. Okay, and now we're going to hit start measuring, and we'll see it go up and down to every point on this grid, and it'll mark the height. All right, we have our wooden spoon in there. You can see the curve. It'll do 49 points, and I'm gonna click start measuring now. I added some blocks here to hold it in, just to be on the safe side. So let us click start measuring, and it should start measuring all by itself, and there it goes. It starts measuring the height of height and position of every point. All right. Now that that's completed, let's go on to programming our design. Okay, it's finished mapping the surface, and it shows me here the nice grid and everything. Now you can go over here and you can adjust the smoothness if you'd like, the tension between the lines, meaning how straight it's going to be between point to point. Or you can select a measurement point to measure again. But it's not bad, we'll leave it like it is. Click done, and it shows me this is my processing area right here. So I have something programmed ready to go here. We're going to zoom in. And make it as big as possible. There we go. All right. We're going to set our parameters. All right, so here's our full file we're going to be doing. Little says, Nan cooks with love, with a little picture of grandmother with a baking cookies. Cute. Now, when you're doing a curved surface, if you select your speed, your speed is set at a maximum of 30. It cannot go any higher. Alrighty, so that looks good. Let's frame it in and start engraving. Alright, so let's frame that in and we'll start engraving. Click frame. Looks good. Let us engrave it. And start. Let us remove it. Let us see what we have. All right. And there we have Nan cooks with love on a 3D surface. Curved. Alright, there we have our 3D surface. It says Nan cooks with love. Came out pretty good. Now, one word of caution. When you're doing a curved surface, your speed is limited to a max of 30 millimeters per second. Now, at that speed, I would lower my power by at least half to three quarters. Because since it's going slower, you don't want it to burn really bad, okay? At a faster speed, no problem. But since it's a curved surface, you're limited to 30 millimeters per second. Just a word of warning, all right? Most people don't know this, but... And when mapping an area, for example, on this one here, I would love to have mapped the outside to get a much more bigger image, but you're limited to a rectangle, and that brings in the edges a little bit. Now, if there's a way around it, I don't know it yet, but I will look into it. Alrighty. So this can be applied to many things. One other item I did, which was it wasn't a curved surface, but it was a irregular surface. Let me show you. One other, here's another project I've done. Godzilla on a rock. Now the rock is not flat. It's very uneven. So I did the mapping of the surface, and I did a lot of points with this one because there's a lot of dips inside of it, raised areas, another dip here, very irregular. So when you have a very irregular radical surface, more points should be required. A constant nice curve, then you'd need less points. Alrighty. I hope this helps everybody. Hit like if you like it. Send me more ideas. I'm willing to try anything new. I'll try anything once. Alrighty. As for now, I'm Johnny Laser. Happy lasering. That's right.